Oh, shit. Do I just keep pressing it?
From the bondage of Olympus and cleansed in chaos, mankind is now ready to hear my message.
Look around you, Athena. The world stands in ruin. What good is your message?
Go if you must. But first, I insist you give me the power from inside the box.
The box was empty.
That can't be true. I can see it in your eyes. You used my power to kill Zeus. You still have it as we speak. Don't you understand? When Zeus gathered all the evils and placed them in the box, I dreaded what would happen if it was opened again. And so, I summoned the most powerful weapon in the world, and I placed it in the box.
Told you, it was empty. Pandora was sacrificed in vain. She died because of my need for vengeance.
You must be mistaken. You used my power to kill Zeus. I saw you do it. Unless... Of course. When you opened the box, you released the evils to the gods. Infected them. Changed them. Zeus himself fell prey to the dark evils. This is why he became so enraged and obsessed with your death. He was consumed by the evil, fear. I thought the power I placed in the box was never released. All these years, I assumed you drew from the evils inside to destroy Ares. But I was wrong. From the box is mine. From it, you gained the strength that Zeus could never destroy. A strength great enough to overcome fear. Locked deep inside of you, Kratos, is hope. It has remained buried, trapped.
That explains why every time you killed one of them, that's something would happen afterwards.
You must have allowed something to awaken it. What was it, Kratos?
Hope is what makes us strong. It is why we are here. It is what we fight with when all else is lost.
What was it, Kratos?
All I remember is what I have lost.
That is why you should give me the power. I understand its true meaning and where it belongs. I trust you to do the right thing, Kratos.
You shouldn't.
You owe me this, Kratos.
I owe you nothing.
I made you a god. I sheltered you from the wrath of Olympus. I delivered your revenge on Zeus.
It is over, Athena.
You would dare strike me down? Again?
My vengeance ends now.
How could you? You disappoint me, Spartan.
And that is it for God of War 3. Looks like I can't skip it. So, if I had to sum up how I feel about this game, is my least favorite hack and slash game I've played so far. Now, that's not saying the game is horrible or bad. I just didn't like it as much as Lollipop Chainsaw, or say Metal Gear Revengeance, or even say some Spider-Man games that can be considered hack and slash. I mean, it was good, you know, and for a remaster edition, it looks okay. I mean, you can definitely tell that the design on, say, Kratos is the main, like, you can definitely see the difference they did with Kratos in this game. Because I even looked at some pictures. While the setting designs just don't look they still look like PS3 era, and they don't look like they're much evolved. Some characters do look a lot better. I will say they actually do look pretty good. Not great, but pretty good. But Kratos, I think, is the one that definitely looks the best. Story-wise, I liked it. Can't really compare it or say much else because I haven't played the other ones. I can't say if it's a good ending to the trilogy. Well, technically it's not the ending because there's a prequel and they're apparently going to be making a sequel. Well, a sequel or... I don't know. But either way, Kratos, though, I hate Kratos. First time playing a God of War game and I don't like Kratos at all. Douchebag. He's just a douchebag. Yep, Clancy Brown played Hades. But, Elijah Wood was in here? Special thanks, Elijah Wood. But yeah, that's pretty much all I can really say about this game. Not my favorite hack and slash game, but I did enjoy it. You know, I don't really have too much to complain about. You know, like I said, my real main complaint was just Kratos. I just didn't like him. And I didn't like Pandora. And some of her dialogue was... made me want to punch her in the mouth. Like, it was very, just felt... I don't know, I just didn't like her dialogue. She just was like a whiny brat. But that's pretty much all I can say about this game. I would give it a... 8 out of 10. Personally, I would give it an 8 out of 10. Don't really know why, because I didn't really have too much to complain about, but I would personally just give it an 8 out of 10. Oh, and then Dante's Inferno, too. Dante's Inferno, personally, is probably my favorite hack and slash game. But that's also because I don't know why. I'm not a religious guy, but I have this thing where I do like how games take their own little, or movies, take their own route with religious figures. Like, if I have to say, like, my favorite religion, and that actually sounds really stupid when I say it out loud, but if there's one religion or mythology, I'll say mythology, because it sounds better. I always loved learning about Greek mythology. I've always liked it. I've always liked learning about Zeus, Hades, Hermes, all the gods. And I personally, even though Dante's Inferno doesn't involve that, I did like Dante's Inferno more. Because, you know, Dante's Inferno was a completely different type of religion, mythology, whatever. And this was different, you know, it's completely different, but I do think Dante's Inferno was easily my favorite hack and slash game. And this is probably the lowest one. And, you know, that's kind of saying something. Lollipop Chainsaw, it wasn't that. A lot of people didn't like Lollipop Chainsaw. I personally did enjoy it because it was just really goofy and over the top. And it wasn't something to take seriously on. And Metal Gear Revengeance, well, that game was super fun. I actually wish I owned it. But it was super fun, and the music was just amazing. But, yeah, I would give this game an 8 out of 10.